Our mission statement. As a welcoming committee of faith, our mission is to glorify God by building a local church family which extends the kingdom of God educationally, mind, physically, body, and spiritually, spirit, in accordance with God's word. Our statement of faith. We believe the Bible to be the only infallible written word of God. We believe that there is one God, eternally existent in three manifestations, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, which is the totality of divine completeness. We believe in the sanctifying power of the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us through the redemptive work of Christ being on the cross. We believe in the indwelling of the Holy Ghost according to Acts 2:4, which enables Christians to live a holy and sanctified life. We believe that faith in God through Jesus provides healing for humankind in answer to believing prayer. We believe that this faith is given to all men, in spite of race, creed, or color. All can be saved.
Greetings, this is Bishop Darrell Hill of the Powerhouse Church in Brooklyn, New York. I have great news for you. The Lord has given us opportunity whereby we can purchase in the midst of a pandemic. Yes, I know it sounds strange, but God has opened the door for us to own our own property. Listen, the Bible says in the book of Joshua 18 and the third verse, it says, "And Joshua said unto the children of Israel, how long are ye slack to go to possess the land which the Lord God of your fathers have given you? The time is right now, and we want you to be a part of it. You can join us in our Power Move campaign. The Power Move Project is what we're calling it, and you can sow on three different levels. You can sow $1,000, $500, or $250. Listen, you're sowing into good ground. We are purchasing property in the midst of a pandemic. For more information, we want you to visit our website, www.powerhousechurchny.org. Once again, that's www.powerhousechurchny.org. Power Move. Come on and be a part of the move. God bless you.
Praise the Lord and welcome to the Powerhouse Church. Thank you for sharing your time and space with us on today. We are excited to have you. To all our parishioners and our supporters, we love you. Thank you so much. We want to also take this time to say thank you for all those who sowed in the Power Move. Thank you so much for your contributions. People are still sowing. Amen. Pastors are sowing, and we want to say thank you from the bottom of our heart. Later on, we're going to do a thank you video once everything is said and done. Amen. Thanking all the pastors for your gifts and all the sowing that's been happening since we started to make this move. Thank you so much for supporting the Power Move. Amen. There is a word from the Lord. We had been in this month of November. We've been in talking about risky business. Bless the name of God. And anytime you're doing a work for the Lord, the enemy is always going to fight you on every side. Amen. And it's a risk you take. Bless the name of God. But God is able to do all things but fail. I want to focus your attention to the book of Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. The book of Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. And we will commence reading at the first verse, going down to the fourth verse. Just four verses. Bless the name of God. Once again, that's Nehemiah, the sixth chapter, first verse down to the fourth verse. Bless the name of God. Nehemiah 6 and 1 reads on this wise. Now it came to pass when Sanballat and Tobiah and Geshem the Arabian and the rest of our enemies heard that I had built the wall and that there was no breach left therein, though at the time I had not set up the doors upon the gates, that Sanballat and Geshem sent unto me, saying, come, let us meet together in some one of the villages in the plain, of Ono, but they thought to do me mischief. And I sent messengers unto them, saying, I am doing a great work, so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease whilst I leave it and come down to you? Yet they sent unto me four times after this sort, and I answered them after the same manner. The word of the Lord is blessed. I want to reiterate in your hearing the third and the fourth verse reads on this wise. And I sent messengers unto them, saying, I am doing a great work, so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease whilst I leave it and come down to you? Yet they sent unto me four times after this sort, and I answered them after the same manner. I want to use for thought on today, this morning into this afternoon, stay in your element. Stay in your element. Stay in your element. It's important for us to understand the importance of being in a place that God has sanctioned you to be. That we do not get so antsy with the difficulties of our space, so much so that we remove ourselves from being positioned in a place or area that God has called us. It reminds me of the first time that I had gone fishing. Myself and a couple of the brethren from the church, at the time a couple of years ago, we went out to the Hamptons and we went fishing. And it was an amazing experience. This was my first time ever fishing. I didn't know how difficult fishing could be. But there was a lesson that I learned in fishing. And so we prepared to fish, and as we got out the boat, we went out into the deep because we were looking to catch striped bass, the big ones. And the captain of the boat was telling us, if we're going to get the big bass, we got to go out into the deep. And he had this little radar that kind of told us where the bass was. We went out there and I threw my rod out and I caught a bite. Fish was a big fish. It was 32 pounds. And the amazing thing is the struggle that I had to go through as the fish and I was fighting. And one thing I understood as I reflect on it and pay attention to it, that if I was going to lose, the fish had to pull me into his element. And if the fish was going to lose, I had to pull him into my element. The strength was the fact that he was in his element and I was in my element. And the difficulty of fishing was I was trying to pull him out of his element while he was trying to pull me out of my element. And what I've noticed about the fish is that once I got the fish on board, that the fish was not as strong as he was when he was in the water, his element. And what I learned through fishing is that they told me that the striped bass is smart, that when they get on the hook, what they do, they open their mouths and allow their bodies to take in a whole lot of water. So now pulling the fish out of the water becomes more difficult because he's in his element and he knows how to operate in his element. And the only way I'm going to win this fight between myself and the fish is I got to pull him out of his element because he's more weaker out of his element. Yes, 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 that was a great lesson, because what I started to understand is that's just what the enemy does to us. He wants to pull us out of our element. He wants to get us out of our space of worship and praise. If he can get you out of the space of worship and praise and get you figuring out, trying to figure out what you're going through, if he can get you in a space where you start to worry and you start complaining, then you become weaker in your faith. Hence, the enemy can destroy you. The only reason why I beat that fish that day is because the fish did not pull me in his element. I pulled him in my element, taking him out of his element. And that's what you need to understand, that right now the enemy is using distractions trying to pull you out of your element. Some of you understand and you realize that there are some things that are going on in your life that are taking most of your time, and you really have time to pray. You really have time to worship. You really have time to praise. Some of you right now, you're attending to other things while we're in worship right now, because there are distracting things going on around you, distractions constantly going on around you, trying to pull you out of your element, because the enemy knows the only way he can beat you if he gets you out of your element. Yes, some of us, we've been called to serve and called to do particular things in the kingdom of God, called to do a particular work, and that things come with that work. Those difficult things come with that work that you have to understand. You have to stay on your post. You have to stay in your element. What God has called you to do and gifted you to do and anointed you to do becomes your element. Singers must sing. Sometimes singers, they can sing their way out of a situation, sing their way out of depression, sing their way out of hardship. Preachers sometimes have to look at themselves in the mirror and preach to themselves what they've been preaching to the congregation. Worshipers have to get to a space where they can release worship. Musicians, sometimes when they go into difficult things, they find themselves playing their instrument all by themselves just to relieve them of the stress that they've been going through, because that's their element. Where you work becomes your element. Where you serve becomes your element. And the key factor here is, if the enemy is going to beat you, he got to get you out of your element. How many times you wanted to quit because of distractions? How many times you've gone through things in your private life and wanted to walk away from what you were assigned to do? It was the enemy trying to work you out of your element. Come to preach to somebody and tell you, stay encouraged and stay in your element. If God has called you to do something in the kingdom of God, do it. If he called you to work in the house of God, work it. Whatever God has called you to do and gifted you to do, make sure you do it, because that's the only way you're going to survive and complete your assignment. The enemy, he wants you to do an incomplete. He wants you to miss your mark and miss your purpose. Here, this is exactly what's happening in this particular text. Nehemiah, who is a cupbearer to the king, he has a weight on him. The weight is the fact that Jerusalem, this is place of worship, Judah, the place, the city of David, has now burned. The temples are down and everything is messed up, and he wants to rebuild Jerusalem. He has to rebuild the walls. He has this sad countenance on him as he is serving the king at Xerxes. And as Xerxes looks at him and says, what is the problem? He says, I cannot be in a happy, cheerful mood when I see my city, when I see the place of my worship burnt down in flames, the gates are burnt and the walls are down to rubbish. He gets in with the king, and the king allots him the opportunity to go back to Judah, to Jerusalem, where he is to build back the walls of the city. I need you to understand, he has now this assignment that is placed on him. He has the go ahead from the king, but there are people who are there who are trying to stop him from building back the walls. He understands this is his assignment. This becomes his element. This becomes the very thing that he begins to live in. This becomes the very thing that builds him up and strengthens him. This is his element. And while he is there building, there is some distractions that come. You need to understand this. You need to understand this. The element is your chemistry. It is a place where your natural habitat is. It is a place where you can activate all your gifts and your talents. It is now Nehemiah who has now been sent back to Judah, Jerusalem, there to build up the city. And while he is there,
There are individuals who are trying to stop him, because anytime God has given you an assignment on your life, anytime you begin to understand your destiny, the enemy tries to stop you. And I need you to understand, he's not coming just one way. He's coming in several different ways. That's why some of you are going through several different things all at once. That's why you're stressed out in one area and stressed out in the next area. That's why when one thing happens, several things happen. They say when it rains, it pours. The Bible tells us here in Nehemiah, the 6th chapter, it is now Nehemiah who has now been given the task to build back the walls. He is there building and working, and he's going through a series of challenges while he's building and working. Here it is. The Bible tells us he's working so much so he has a set of people working on this gate and another set on the other gate. They are building at record time. He's hearing all the people, the naysayers, talk about what he's building, saying that it's going to come to rubbish, saying that if a fox come against it, it will knock the wall down. They're saying all these negative things, yet it is Nehemiah who is still building. See, you got to still do what God has called you to do in spite of what people are saying. You got to clog your ears to the naysayers. The Bible goes on to tell us the story. Nehemiah's building. He's so much so building. They're threatening his life and threatening the builders. The Bible tells us in one text that Nehemiah sets them up by families. He puts tools in one hand, glory be to God, and weapons in the next hand, which gives us an understanding. When you're building, you got to learn how to defend yourself. God will never give you the tools to build and not give you the tools to defend yourself. I need you to understand that he's building, and while they're building with one hand, there's tools to in one hand, and then there's weapons in the next hand. They get the wall built. They shut up all the breaches. And the Bible says in the 6th chapter, now it came to pass when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem the Arabian and the rest of our enemies, understand there's more than one that was working against them, heard that I had built the wall and that there was no breach left therein. Glory be to God. That Sanballat and Geshem sent unto me saying, come, let us meet together. Oh, look at the next tactic. When they knew they couldn't stop him from building, when they knew they couldn't get him where he was weak, when they knew that they couldn't stop him from stopping up the breaches, when they knew, glory be to God, that they had weapons because they were prepared to fight for what they were building, they tried to distract him and remove him away from the wall to get him out of his element. I come to tell you, those of you who are dealing with the enemy on every side, you're becoming frustrated at some of the turmoil that you've been going through, because you've been faithful in the midst of your assignment. The Lord is telling you, don't you dare leave your element. Stay right where God called you to work. Do what God has called you to do. If you're a singer, sing. If you're a deacon, do the deacon work. If you're a preacher, preach. But stay in your element. If you're a musician, stay where you are. Stay in your element. Because if the enemy can get you away from your element, he can defeat you. Glory be to God. It is Nehemiah who understands this. And as he is now given, glory be to God, he's given the invitation to sit down and meet. Glory be to God. They want him to come to the villages in the plain of Ono. Oh, glory be to God. But he said, oh no. They wanted to do mischief to him. They wanted to catch him off guard. They didn't want to sit down and have a conversation. They just wanted to distract him. And I need some of you to understand that this is an oh no moment for you. These are some people people, you got to tell no. No, thank you. You can't sit with everybody. You can't talk with everybody. Everybody can't take your space and your time up. Glory be to God. He was wise enough to understand that they wanted to do mischief to him. And look at his response. He sends messengers unto them saying, I am doing a great work so that I cannot come down. Glory be to God. I need somebody who understands you're doing something great, and the enemy wants to distract you. He wants to remove you from your assignment. He wants to remove you, glory be to God, out of your element. He says, why should the work cease whilst I leave it and come down to you? Glory be to God. He understands you are trying to distract me. You can't stop me from building. You can't hinder the strength of the wall. You can't stop me from building up the breaches. The only way the enemy can get you is to remove you out of your element. Oh, I'm talking to the worshipers now. I'm talking to the praisers now. God is saying, get back to praise. Get back to worship. Get back to your prayer life. Get back to fasting. Get back to reading the scriptures. Get back to the place that keeps you in your element, so that you will not weaken yourself and lose the battle. He said, yet they sent unto me four times after this sort, and I answered them after the same matter. I need you to understand Nehemiah. He goes back to Judah, Jerusalem, and he builds up the walls. He completes the assignment. I need you to understand there was distractions on every side, and he accumulated enemies, not because he was a bad person, not because he did anything ill towards anyone, but he accumulated enemies because he meant to do a work. He had something he had to build, and I came to preach to you builders to tell you, you got enemies not because you're a bad individual. You got enemies because you made up your mind to build and to do the work. But the Lord sent me here to tell you this morning into this afternoon, don't you dare lose yourself by leaving your element. Stay on the wall. That's what I came to preach to you about. I came to tell you, stay on the wall. I came to encourage every musician. I came to encourage every servant in the house of God. The Lord is saying, stay on the wall. Keep doing the work. Don't you dare stop. Don't you dare get distracted. The enemy wants to remove you from your element. But I dare you to lift your hands and make a vow to the Lord and tell the Lord, I'm going to serve you till the day I die. Many may come, many may go, but I made up my mind to serve you. I'm going to build it. I'm going to build the wall. I came to tell somebody who's a builder. I came to preach to all the builders who has nothing to work with, but God has given you favor. He's given you resources. He's given you people who will help you build to keep working. When it gets weak, keep on working. When it gets tiring, keep on working. God is saying, don't you dare leave your element. I need somebody to get in your element right now. You were looking at your bills. You were looking at your money. He was looking at the lack. And the Lord told me to tell you, he sees it. He knows it. And you want to stop praising your God. You wanted to stop giving him the worship. You wanted to stop serving in the kingdom. But the Lord is saying, don't you dare leave your element. telling me, I'm about to bless you with success. I'm about to bless you. I know it's risky to stay on the wall. I know you had folk who don't like you for no reason, because you're on the wall. But build it. Keep on building. Build till they talk about you. Build till they lie on you. Build until they mistreat you. But keep on building. Don't leave your element. Your strength is in you building and working in the kingdom of God. I need somebody. Look at somebody in your house and tell them, I was about to quit. I was about to come down off the wall to address some things, but I decided to stay on the wall. I'm doing a great work, and somebody who believes you're doing a great work, lift your hands right where you are and tell the devil, I'm doing a great work, and I can't come down. Somebody shout yes. Somebody shout hallelujah. Keep on working. Keep on building. Keep on staying in your element. Brick by brick, mortar by mortar. Build it. Build it. Build it. Build it. Stay in your element. Yeah. The enemy been trying to get you out of your element. He's been trying to distract you, but stay in your element. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Keep on building. Keep on working. Keep on your assignment. Say yes. Keep on building. Keep on building. If he can get you off the wall, if he can get you out of your assignment, he can weaken you, thus destroying you and giving you an incomplete. How many things you started and it was working, and then you got distracted? The enemy, what I'm learning is, he's not going to come so abrasive. He's going to come in the most subtle way. They sent letters saying, we just want to talk to you. The enemy understands that your ear gate is an important part of your success. What you listen to and who you listen to can determine the outcome of your endeavors. You have to be careful in this season who you allow in your ear. Nehemiah says, no, no, I will not come down. I will not come down. I must stay on the wall. I am doing a great work. Why should the work cease and I leave it just to come talk to you? I'm telling you right now, my brothers and sisters, you don't have time to deal with little issues that don't mean nothing in completing your task. Stay on the wall. Stay in your element. There may be someone right now, you say, Bishop Hill, I was distracted so many times. I left the church because I've heard some things. I listened to people who put
posed as friends, but they were really enemies. Watch this. Jesus looks at Judas and calls him friend when he kisses him on the cheek. And then when Peter is trying to prevent him from going to the cross, he tells Peter, Satan, get thee behind me. Because your friends are those who push you towards destiny, and your enemies are those who try to keep you away from your destiny. And sometimes destiny has difficulties mixed into it. You have to be wise enough. Your friends will tell you the truth. They will push you to what God wants you to become. I want to pray with you. You who've been distracted. You've been taken off course. You who left your assignment and left your post because of what people said or things you heard. God says you're out of your element. Get back into your element. That's why the enemy's getting you. And it seems like you're having a whole bunch of fun right now. Seems like things are going. It's all a setup. Because he wants to build you all the way up just to let you drop. Because he knows the higher he takes you up, make you feel good, that the drop can be more devastating. God says, get back to your element. Don't you leave your element. Those of you who are doing what God has called you to, don't you leave your element. I know it's getting hard. It gets hard. Don't leave it. But I thank God that he's married to the backslider. Those of you who are not saved and you want to be saved, or you left the church and you want to come back to God, this is your opportunity to get back into your element. You know you're a Christian. You know God has got an anointing on your life. You know you can't just live in lasciviousness, doing whatever you want to do. God has more for you.
Yes, I believe.
Point your right hand. We're going to go over the sinner's prayer. Point your right hand towards me. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we made mess. We messed up. We've broken your law. We've broken your word. But we believe by faith that you are forgiving God, that you're married to the backslider. And we believe that if we believe the word according to the scriptures, we believe that you sent your son Jesus Christ through Immaculate Conception to come into the world to save the world from its sin, from our sins. If we believe that he lived and suffered under Pontius Pilate, that he was beaten and crucified, that he was put on a tree, on a cross, that he died, giving up the ghost, and was placed in a borrowed tomb, and 3 days later he rose with all power in his hand, and he sits at your right hand making intercession for us that we shall be saved. Thank you for saving us. Now, Father, lead us and guide us. Lead us and guide us. We want to be filled and refilled in the mighty name of Jesus. Lead us and guide us to a place where we can go and grow in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you. Welcome to the kingdom of God. You're saved. You're back in. Don't leave your element. Stay where God has called you to be. Bless the name of God. I want to pray for all those who are listening, you viewing. I want to pray that God will give you the strength to stay on the wall. Stay in your element. That when the enemy comes, he put a hook. The way the fish defends itself is by opening its mouth. Do you know there were other brothers that were there who were fishing with me that got the hook in the fish? But when the fish opened its mouth in its element, it got away. Opens its mouth so that more water can come in. God is saying, you want to be strengthened, open your mouth. Speak. Open your mouth. Declare it. Open your mouth. I want to pray for you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. As your hand is pointing to the screen, Father, we pray, God, for these who are working and serving in the kingdom of God, these who have an assignment on their life, these who are called for greater and more. Father, I pray right now that they will be strengthened. Lord, that they will not be distracted out of their place, out of their purpose, but they will stay right where you assigned them to be, that they will build the wall in the mighty.
mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and we praise you. We pray, God, that you will strengthen them right now, because the adversary is going to come. It's not a matter if he will come, it's when he will come. Father, we pray right now that you will strengthen them. Keep them, keep their minds, keep their heart, keep their spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you. We lift you up and give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.
Yes, I
God bless you. Stay strong in your faith.
It belongs to me.
We are preparing to give our tithes. We are a blessed house because we are a tithing house. We believe in the giving of the tenth. We want you to repeat after us this proclamation. Bless the name of God. Get yourselves ready with your tithes. A tithe is not a seventh part, but it's a tenth. It's not a fifth, it's a tenth. 10%. Bless the name of God. God says, if you give me the 10, I'll bless your 90. Bless the name of God. Put your right hand towards the screen and repeat after me. I hereby enter into the sacred covenant with God.
I hereby enter into the sacred covenant with God.
To tie to the source of my spiritual teachings.
To tie to the source of my spiritual teachings.
I do this with the understanding.
I do this with the understanding.
That God did not institute the tithe.
That God did not institute the tithe.
To bring us under the law.
To bring us under the law.
But to give blessings to me and my household.
But to give blessings to me and my household.
I also understand. This is a sacred agreement.
That this is a sacred agreement.
Between me and God.
Between me and God.
I am invoking this relationship. And bringing it to the forefront of my life. Keep those hands raised. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise for these, your tithers. We ask that you bless them according to your word. For you said in your word, if we were proof, we now here with the tenth, that you would open up the winds of heaven and pour us out a blessing that we don't even have room enough to receive. You said that you rebuked the devourer for our sake, and that our master that cast us from before season, but in due season will certainly come to pass, and all nations shall call us blessed. We take you at your word. Now, Father, we pray, God, that you do more for these than they can anticipate. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Y'all go ahead. Use the text to give. It's coming on the screen. Go to the website. Give your time. Bless the name of God. We're preparing for our offering. We are a giving church. That's why we're blessed. We're a giving church. We're giving people. Bless the name of God. Those of you who prepared $100 or so, I want you put it up on the screen. That's how we're giving. Put it up on the screen. Put that $100 on the screen. We want to see you. Bless the name of God. Bless the name of God. We want to do this as a point. Amen. Of encouragement. Bless the name of God. And some of you may not have. We know we're in the pandemic. We are cognizant of that. But God has been blessing right in the midst of this pandemic. We've still been able to give and still been able to sow. Still got shelter. Bless the name of God. Still got our jobs. Bless the name of God. God is so good. Amen. Those of you who are sowing 100, go ahead and sow it. Put it up. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Amen. Bishop Hill, I don't have 100, but I set aside $50 that I can sow. I want you to sow that 50. Go ahead and put that up on the screen. Courage. Go ahead. Encourage. Sow it. When you sow, say, I'm sowing this for, amen, my business. I'm sowing this for some health. I'm sowing this for healing. Amen. Pronounce it. Speak it. Bless the name of God. Open your mouth. Bless the name of God. Bishop Hill, I don't have the 50, but I set aside $25 that I can sow. I want you to come and sow it. Go ahead, put it up. Put it up. We thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Amen. It's not the amount you give, but the spirit in which you give it. We are not trying to get something from you. We're trying to get something to you. Bless the name of God. Amen. Bless the name of God. Bishop, I don't have $25. I want you to get the best you got. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, quarter, dime, nickel, penny, whatever you have. Bless the name of God. Sow it. Sow it. So whatever you have, sow it. Bless the name of God. Sow it and God will grow it. I'm telling you. Release it. God will do it.
Bless the name of God. Amen. Put it up.
Yes,
put
it up.
I don't care if it's a dime, a nickel. Put it up. Amen. Bless the name of God. This is not about the amount. It's about the spirit in which you give it. Bless the name of God. Come on, givers, I want to pray with you. Point your right hand towards this direction, towards your screen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We praise for these, your givers. We ask that you bless them according to your word. For you said, you want to give a seed to the sower and bread to the eater. You're sustaining your word, given it shall be given unto us in good measure. Pressed down, shall gather, run over, shall men give unto us. We take you at your word. Now, Father, we pray that you do more for these than they can anticipate. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bless the name of God. Amen. Go ahead. Post your praise. Post your praise. Amen. Your praise is to your money what water is to seed. It helps it grow. Bless the name of God. We thank you. We love you. Listen, be encouraged. Amen. And we want to again say thank you to those of you who joined in to the power move. Amen. You know, to the Powerhouse Church, you know what we were asked to do for November 23rd. That was in-house. Amen. Some of you have already been doing it. I have done it. Bless the name of God. Some of you have already sown yours. Thank you so much. Some of you made pledges. Amen. So that we can obtain this property. Bless the name of God. God is so good. Amen. Years ago, people prophesied, came and prophesied that we will go into ownership, and now it is here. Amen. And we thank you so much. Amen. Once again, to all the pastors and bishops, those of you, amen, who have sown seed towards the work, thank you so much. Amen. We're going to come at a later date, amen, and say thank you to everyone, naming everyone, amen, because we are just that grateful. God bless you. Remember, if you got the faith, God has the power. We love you. God bless you.
And thank you so much for joining in our worship experience this morning. We are so glad to have you. We are so grateful for all of the many things that we have been able to do during this time, and it is because of your giving. And yes, it's offering time at this time. There are three safe ways that you can choose to be a part of our giving experience this morning. You can log on to www.powerhousechurchny.org. Again, our website is www.powerhousechurchny.org. Or you can go to your local Google or Apple store on your mobile device and download the Powerhouse Church NY app. Yes, the Power app is available. You can also give by texting the word GIVE to 718-690-7334. Again, text the word GIVE to 718-690-7334. We are so glad that you have decided to share with us and sow your seeds, and we are so excited about what the Lord is going to continue to do in your life. Remember, if you have the faith, God has the power.
What a powerful service we had today. Thank you once again for sharing your time and space with us. We want you to stay connected with us by going to our Facebook page, The Powerhouse Church NY, or go to our website, www.powerhousechurchny.org. Once again, thank you so much for sharing your time and space, whether it's on Facebook or in person. We're excited to have you here. Remember, if you got the faith, God has the power.